What's up, guys? It's your boy right here. That's me. And today, we are here for Madden Week 7, the NFC for an NFC East rivalry game between the Dallas Cowboys and the Philadelphia Eagles. So, let me tell you something before we start. Why we didn't do Week 6 between the Detroit Lions? Because I was on my four-day weekend vacation at that log cabin, which I gave you a tour of. So that's why we couldn't do Week 6, but I'm back here once again. So you guys are ready? Okay, let's go.
All right, we got our uniform set up and we're ready.
Okay. Alright, here we go. Live from Philly. Today, from Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, this is the National Football League. Channing, let's go Eagles instead of Cowboys, because it's the Eagles Stadium, of course. Cowboys won the toss and they will defer. So the Eagles will get the ball first. Alright, here comes Jalen Hurts. First down for Philly now. Alright, here we go. Alright, Jalen Hurts back to pass. Incomplete. Oh, they call an injury timeout early. Okay. Second down. Oh, he's gone. All right, now first down and 10 for Philly now. Oh, fumble. Slammed him down. Wow. Unbelievable. Here comes Dak Prescott. Zeke Elliott. And he gets it inside the 10 and the 9. That good for 19 and a first down. Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea. Slow him
Oh my God, why? I really didn't mean to fake it.
Oh, and now they're gonna fake it. And he is not gonna make it.
Oh, Cooper Rush is down.
6-0 ball game. And now it looks like we've got a Cowboy shaken up down there on the field. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break.
Oh God. We're still on top, 6-0.
So they went for two and failed. They didn't use him on the PAT, but now he boots this one away with a 6-0 lead. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
All right.
So on the field, here come the Eagles for their second drive.
Wait, who's that QB? I thought he was not supposed to be on the field. That's not Jalen Hurts, guys. Okay, substitute him.
Get yourself set to play defense, but when you turn it over, it changes momentum, and when they take it down through and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be.
Okay. Jalen Hurts back to pass. Oh, there's a flag. I thought. Oh, now Jalen Hurts is still on the field, but number 6 is a wide receiver. Holding. Accept.
So a decent game, but all for naught on the bell.
Yeah, they didn't feel pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Hurts. All right.
And this almost intercepted.
Oh, yes.
A good throw there, nearly an opening drive, INT.
That's 2nd and 19 for Philly. What's going on with Philly today? It's that, I don't know why. 3rd and 18.
Just a gain of one there. Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw.
All right, now they got a punt.
This will not get close to the first down marker as he's brought down at the 26. A gain of 9, not enough, and it's 4th down. The punt team on now as this one sent away.
All right, CeeDee Lamb. CeeDee Lamb. Side zone.
So from 2nd and long, now we go to 3rd and very manageable.
Well,
that phrase, don't think, because as an offensive coordinator, you can keep people a little bit off balance and guessing because you don't have to throw it. You come back with a strong run game if you want to. And if you're
right
out territory, that really opens things up for you.
47 yards rushing for him now and just 6 carries to this point. Now they're making a real first quarter statement with a run game, no doubt.
For those remember old school football, running it, establishing things, seeing backs find holes, get thrown. They got life in their sand from this unit so far. Right now, they've decided to say, as you said, establish the run game, and they've been successful.
Oh my God.
Credit the tackle to Darius Slay.
got a yard. Here's second and nine. Again to Elliott. A gain of two there on the heels of a 1 yard pickup on first.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're not doing the dictating on defense. And guess what?
We're on the defense, champ. Defense. What down is it? I want to go for it. Oh, fourth and three. I think I should kick a field goal. Oh, but that's the end of the first quarter. We're about to... All right. Since... Okay, now we got to kick a field goal. Fourth and short. Okay, I think we're going to go for it this time. Fumble, but we get it back. Yeah.
That ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like...
Right now it is first down and 10 for Dallas after that fourth down conversion. Oof, almost intercepted. Now it's first down for Dallas, and
almost
intercepted by Philly. That would have been terrible. I think Dak should run it to the into the end zone. Oh no. Maybe that was a stupid idea anyway. Oh. Fletcher Cox.
And it appears to me that someone's defensive coordinator is jockeying for a raise. A sack on second and goal, a sack on third and goal. Now brings up a decision on fourth down.
Got it. God, that was terrible. Here comes the offense.
So there's optimism because they've improved, right? Turnover, you just noted it.
Once better than turnover.
The punt is better on the second one. Now they're opening.
It sticks.
Time rolls around. Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando.
All right, we're at the 2-minute warning now. 9-0 Cowboys lead. 4th and inches. They're gonna punt instead of going for it. How could that be stupid? I see D. Lamb. Oh.
The Cowboys about set to take over on offense. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it, forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort.
Right? Incomplete. That's not how a driver's supposed to be. I'm going to call a timeout.
That's a consolation prize. I'm going to the county fair. You don't get a big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material.
All right, here we go.
There's Prescott.
Pop.
That's complete to Dalton Schultz.
Yep, Dalton Schultz. Oh, yeah.
That one good for 26 and a first down.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage. So timing is everything. This time you wait for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
Oh.
Very lucky to get that one back. And nearly picked. It's second down now.
A little trigger happy right there. And it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
But we know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete.
Oh, almost intercepted.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because any completions on first and second down.
All right, here we go. Long range. It is Greg the Leg. Second let's go before halftime. Okay. First down and 10 for Philly. Jalen Hurts back to pass. It's caught. Ooh. Okay, so Philly will try to get on the board with field goal 5 seconds before halftime, and he get it. Another singing fly, Eagles fly. Hey, I know the lyrics to that song though. I know the lyrics to that song. Oh, I only know the opening lyrics. Fly, Eagles, fly, on the road to victory. And they also sang that in the movie Invincible. That's also based off, that movie is based off a true story as we reached the halftime. All right, so we reached halftime. Score is 12-3, Cowboys leading Philly. Man, let me continue telling you about Invincible. So, Invincible is based off a true story about this Eagles fan called Vince Papale who wanted to play for the Philadelphia Eagles. That was like back in the 1970s, but the movie came out in 2006. Well, it's still a good movie. They sang Fly Eagles Fly in that movie. Well, back then it was called Fight Eagles Fight. But So I think they have a good song, but Cowboys have better players. So, even though it's an NFC East rivalry, it's still a good game. So, we'll see you at the kickoff of the second half. All right, we're about to kick off the second half here. All right, Jason Reed kicks it off. Tony Pollard. Stiff arm. Right, Cowboys offense are set to go. Here it goes. Oh, Zeke Elliott. Bro, if you will go to an Eagles game, you would hear Fly Eagles Fly when they score, when Philadelphia scores. Like, bro, if the Cowboys were playing in Philly in real life, then I would fly to Philly, get tickets for the game, and then watch the Cowboys beat the shit lap out of Philly. that's a joke that I got from my mom after Baylor beat Oklahoma, and they handed, and Oklahoma was undefeated. Like, that's crazy. Touchdown Cowboys. and that happened to the Falcons last Sunday. This Sunday we're playing the Chiefs. Hey, I like Pat Mahomes. I like Pat Mahomes. I like Tyreek Hill. I like Tyrann Mathieu. Like, those are three Chiefs players that I love. I didn't choose to go for two. 18-3. How could that? And as you know, this in the Madden 22, there's a new event. There's some new features of packages, which is, there's a new event called Bo Knows in Madden 22. It's they have gear for the yard and the Madden the yard store, and they got and you can get Bo Jackson on your ultimate team. I got him already. Well, Bo Jackson also played professional baseball, as you know. He played for the Royals. In 2018, when I was 10 years old, I wanted to go see a Royals game. Two Royals games, I meant. I'll tell you, I had a good experience there. I've been to lots of baseball games in my life. Though they were minor league and major league. Well, sometimes I wish I went to a Dodgers game. So, I had a good time at Globe Life Field on August 15th. And, they had an Andy Ibañez, he, with that jump and catch, I was so surprised. And the Rangers won 7-4. And they were wearing the sky blue jerseys that I was wearing that day. And that was a good experience at Globe Life Field. So I really enjoyed that game. Go watch that video now if you haven't. Anyways, now it's first down for Dallas. What? Is that Jalen Hurts on the field? Did he also plays defense? Oh no, wait. That's not Jalen Hurts. That was his number last year. Number two was his number last year. That was Slade Jr. I would have said that Devonta Smith, the Heisman Trophy winner, he must be killing it with the Eagles. All right, 20 minutes left to go before the fourth quarter. I did protect the ball. Stick. Okay, let's do a as a lot of receivers tight ends, okay, a draw to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
It's a 3-yard pickup and that sets up first and goal. They're bringing a spot right now with convincing lead.
Alright, let's do a QB sneak. Alright, let's try that again, because we're near the end zone. Oh, stopped by Fletcher Cox again. Man, I don't think QB sneak should be a good choice. No, it's not a good choice, by the way. But we reached the fourth quarter now. All right, here we go.
A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal.
All right, fans are jumping. Touchdown, Cowboys. No, I shouldn't have done that. Intercepted. And I shouldn't have faked it anyway. Sunsets on Philly as it's a Cowboys victorious day.
Now after the touchdown, it's Zerline. He'll kick it away. And he'll just take a seat in the driveway to get it to 25-yard line. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think you've got to look at that play sheet. Spot that they haven't called before. Time to shake things up a little bit and try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, realize it
has who did it? Who did it? Sack.
So no sack, he gets back to the line of scrimmage, but it'll still
right now, fourth and five. Yeah.
There was pressure all around him, so the only play was to try and get out of there. I think it was an excellent effort by him just to get back to the line of scrimmage.
And they're indeed gonna go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out.
Yep.
But this one is going to wind up incomplete.
I know.
Unable to convert there on fourth.
Incomplete.
Dallas, they'll take over in terrific field position. But at this stage in the game, in the second half, down three scores, I guess they felt like they needed a push.
And let's face it, with this deficit, they did give up another score here after they didn't get it. Does it really matter?
4 minutes left to go in this game. Oh, now it skips down to 4:35. Let me try the QB run. Let me try the QB sneak. All right. QB sneak. Gronk, the Gronk cue of the Cowboys.
From a yard out, and the Cowboys will extend their lead.
what you need to do. Big guys going up front. Have the field general, the leader, just falling behind him.
Now Greg Zuerlein.
Now we can kick a field goal. Nope. Now we cannot fake it.
That'll increase their lead to 28. The drive there only spanning three plays. And it was all capped off by Dak Prescott, keeping it and taking it in on the touchdown run. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. This is taken just shy of the 10. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape, up past the 30. And out now come the Eagles. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave a great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right?
All right, 4 minutes left in this game. Okay, Jalen Hurts. And stop. All right. And he's sacked. Dance on him, baby.
That right now, that's a defeated team out there. I think you can see it totally in their body language.
Hands on hips, heads low. It's just been a struggle from the start.
Yeah, this team has been thoroughly beaten right from the word go.
Second and 11. Another try after the first down sack. Hurts.
And that was not Zach Hurts, I believe you. Because he got traded to the Cardinals. And I bet he's doing very good there. Oh. Yep, he already gets the first down. Alright, we have reached the 2 minute warning.
So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. Back to throw now on first down. And it's kind of a good off that time as that one falls to the ground. Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. Back to throw again. And he's going to have the hook up to Scott.
Oh, his sticks. First and goal. We need to stop Philly from scoring a touchdown.
Again, he'll drop the throw.
He's got it.
They'll contain it to just four. Second down.
Okay, 1 or 2 left. Just skips down. Final seconds. Jalen Smith. I mean, Jalen Hurts. I meant. All right. Engage fight. Engage fight. Engage fight. 40 seconds left. It is intercepted. Kneel out at the end zone. That's it. Now that's gotta be the Cowboys versus the Eagles version of that interception in the end zone at Super Bowl 49. Like, when Tom Brady was in New England, he was going crazy. Even behind him was Jimmy Garoppolo when he was there. Oh. But that's it, boys. That is done. Alright, that's it. That's all of it. Alright, so final score was 31-3. Cowboys, they just bombed Philly. That's insane. But it's still a good game. Hey, Philly, Jalen Hurts, I think he played very good, but the Cowboys had it today. So I'm going to a Pee Wee football game tonight in Belton, Killeen Trojans game. So, but I won't vlog because I don't want to vlog anymore. Because the Pee Wee season is almost over. I didn't mention all those previously mentioned. I only mentioned that the Pee Wee football season is almost over. So if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe, like, and comment. And I'll see you later. Bye.